Oh, it's great. It's here. Dynamic charts based on dynamic arrays. This is brand new in Insider's beta build 16.0.15.617.10,000 or later. All right, so what I have here is I have a report that's actually built from dynamic arrays, but I only want to chart customer and revenue and only the top N. So here I'm using the filter function, sending that into the sort function. For right now, the chart has to be based on the entire spilled array. Check this out. So right here, when I change this input cell from 4 to 6, the filter then returns more records and the chart automatically returns those records. That's a text box there using a formula to update based on the 6. This is a great improvement. There's some oddities. Like when I look at the series function, they're not using the hash nomenclature. They're just pointing to the whole series, just like a table would do. With a chart built on a table, they don't reference the table, they reference the whole range of the table. And that's the same thing that's gonna happen here. So I select all of this data, go to insert, choose my chart type, and they point to the range of that table, but as that range changes, so we go from 5 to 10, and then come back here and look at the series function, you said they automatically update the series. So it's the same, very similar logic to control T tables. What a great improvement. Watch for that again in Insider's beta. If you're not in Microsoft 365 Insiders, it's easy to join. Just Google how to join Office Insiders and make sure to choose the beta option as opposed to monthly or targeted. Beta gets you the new stuff faster. If you like these videos, please down below, like, subscribe, and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments below. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.